It takes a massive amount of work from the evil side to trip them up. But either way, these sorts of things are what you need to examine yourself on, particularly when you're coming to a serious confession, or if you need to get advice about some part of your life, not necessarily from the priest, because the priests themselves today, including myself, have great difficulty leading the sort of life that we are supposed to be leading. And I could go on for hours talking about why. Yes, there are many forces working against us, many forces. And one has only so much energy and strength to be able to overtake or to cope with those things. Somewhere along the line, one falls. You know, when I finish liturgy and am fixing up the proskynia table for the coming week, I can hear three or four different conversations going on account of the acoustics of this tiny little chapel. I can hear what you're talking about, except if it's in Romanian, and understand what you're saying. Well, don't forget that until the prayers of thanksgiving are finished, which is still part of liturgy, you need to be there quietly, just as you are when the liturgy is going on. So you see, that's the thing that needs to be concentrated on, but it isn't in our parishes. Every time I come out of a service at one of the major parishes, I am sort of like shaken from the great singing and the chanting, and it's like something quite amazing. But then when you think about it, you go out and you say, but spiritually, what did I learn out of that? What did I get out of it? Oh yes, it was beautiful singing and it was lovely. And this goes for just about every jurisdiction in the Orthodox Church, even for those that are not in the Orthodox. You go to the Anglicans and listen to the voices of